Today, everyone is talking about out-of-the-box thinking. But do we really understand what is out-of-the-box thinking, or have we got the essence of it? I mean, a toddler coloring outside the lines, we can't even accept that. Our expectation is trees are green and mountains are brown. Why can't a child color trees purple or yellow or red, or mountains could be any color, white, pink? Why not? But we are not even ready for that. We on one hand are saying that out-of-the-box thinking must be encouraged, but on the other hand, we are making the children fit into these tiny boxes of our society constantly. Well, homeschooling decision for us started, or the thought process started somewhere with these discussions over dinner at 7. So what is homeschooling? Homeschooling is where the parents become the teachers and the children learn from home. Does it mean that they are at home, only at home? No. So they are out and out there exploring and getting a lot of vitamin D. So if we are learning something in history or science, we'll be at science center or a museum or a planetarium to know more about that subject. If we are painting something, we are at a garden or a seashore or a beach to paint. So that is homeschooling, where you make the best use of nature and best use of all the possible resources, not just textbooks and not within the four walls of a classroom, because learning happens everywhere and all the time. Kids learn that, and I think every child learns that way, right? So when you try to push a tumbler in a bucket of water, that's buoyancy, and that's learned some hands-on rather than mugging up the definitions. The need for homeschooling arises when schools become exam centers. When every Monday there's a dictation test and every Thursday there's a surprise test for which the material has been provided to the parents to rectify and get prepared, then there is every month, every second month unit test, and every semester, and I don't know, I mean all those tests and competitions and Olympiads, and the learning, there's no learning time. I mean, I know so many schools where it's like the children are not even let to play with the mud, but there is a pottery competition immediately happening. The kids are just about learning to draw or paint, and there's a painting competition. The kids are just about learning to add, and there's a math Olympiad. I mean, I'm not against competitions. I'm not against examinations. I'm not against the teachers. But there is a problem when the learning is missing out. Everyone is just ignoring the learning part. We are just preparing our kids for short-term memory. We are preparing our kids for one exam after the another, one exam after the another. And we are actually telling, even as parents, as teachers, as whole system together, we all are equally responsible for making our children have this short-term memory, because we are telling them, this exam is over, you don't have to memorize this now. Now let's memorize this, because you're not going to get this portion for the upcoming exam. That's where the problem lies, because learning is something that has to enlighten you, there should be this enjoyment and fun for learning something new every single day. And at the same time, you should be able to remember and understand the concepts forever. Because every single thing that you have learned is important. And what are we trying to convey to our kids? That what you learned in the first semester is not really important, because in the second semester you're not going to answer. You don't have to answer those questions. So in a way, we are telling them that just forget that and remember this. That's where the problem lies. So today, when learning has really stepped outside textbooks and classrooms and has reached in your hands, internet. So there are so many resources available, which I guess even the schools can make use of, right? And make a lot of changes. Sadly, I don't know, but maybe because our education system does not really allow, and we are still into that box, probably, we are not letting us free to learn. So that is one of the reasons why homeschoolers decide to homeschool. Well, coming to the positives and negatives of it, just like, I mean, every coin has two sides, right? So, well, most of the people think the disadvantage of homeschooling is how do kids socialize? Well, I think children, I mean, we humans are social animals, and we don't really need to give a place, okay, this is your, again, I'll use the word box, this is your box, go socialize. These are your peers, go socialize. You don't need to do that, right? So, and luckily, we in India have so many people around us. We are constantly surrounded with people. So there are building people, there are kids when you go to the park, there are people constantly everywhere the same way, and there are children across the ages with whom even the homeschoolers can play with. So I don't think the socialization is really a matter of concern, but still, if you feel, then there are places where even the schoolers go to, right? So there is maybe tennis or swimming or a sport, any sport, where the children can go together and socialize and go for a drama class and socialize. So what is the future of homeschooling? Yes, the homeschoolers get absorbed in the regular board exams for 10th grade. So 10th standard, they can appear for either NIOS, or now we also have MIOS, Maharashtra Institute of Open Schooling, or IGCSE board exam, or SSE board exam. So there are these options through which homeschoolers can appear for board exam. So if the kids are, the homeschooled kids are at the end of the day going to give board exams, why to even homeschool? So why homeschool? Because of the other reasons, where the concepts are getting cleared and where they are learning and they are enjoying the entire process of learning. They are not just studying. Sadly, as shikshanatla phakta abhyas bhag urlela ahe. Shikshan kuthe tari nahisa zhalay. The learning is lost, and we are just studying for another exam. That is where homeschooling helps the children learn, explore, experiment, and enjoy the entire learning process. And then later on, when they have to prepare for board exams, they are prepared to face the exam. So many ask, how can a homeschooler face the competitions? So you can keep them in track with to be aware of how the exams are by giving a little bit of tests or Olympiads in between as they are at higher grades, if you are really scared of that.